Hello YouTube, this is Dazza the cameraman. Today is Wednesday 13th of November 2013. This is a quick response video to a comment that has been left under one of my videos regarding Comet ISON. This is a comment by Brian Kai, and I'm just responding to his comment because I think it's an interesting question, and a number of people have been making statements about Comet ISON, saying that certain things have never happened before regarding Comet ISON. Now, somebody else had actually left a comment under this particular video claiming that certain things had never happened before, and I asked that person to explain to me just what it was that had never happened before. That other person didn't actually get back to me, but as we can see, Brian Kai has responded, and he has said, "Look at the path of ISON, how it goes around the Sun. That is what has never happened before." Now, I'm not having a go at Brian Kai or anything like that. Please don't misunderstand this video. We're just looking at the interesting point that has been raised about the orbit of Comet ISON. Has this ever happened before? Is this something new and unusual? As you can see, I've responded to Brian's comment there, and I've suggested that he Google Comet C1680V1, which is the Great Comet of 1680. There are a couple of articles I looked at. One was on Wikipedia, and you can see that I've summarized some information from Wikipedia there. So C1680V1, also the Great Comet of 1680, became one of the brightest comets of the 17th century, reputedly visible even in daytime, and was noted for its spectacularly long tail, passing 0.42 AUs from the Earth on 30th of November 1680. It sped around an extremely close perihelion, or closest point to the Sun, of 0.0062 AU on 18th December 1680, reaching its peak brightness on 29th December as it swung outwards. It was last observed on 19th of March 1681. As of September 2012, the comet was about 253 AU from the Sun. Now, 1 AU, of course, is the average distance between the Sun and the Earth, which is about 93 million miles or 150 million kilometres. So for every AU, you need to multiply that by the distance in miles or kilometres. So let's have a look. Everybody likes to compare the JPL orbit diagrams. So here is the orbit diagram of C1680V1, and here is the orbit diagram of C2012S1, which is Comet ISON. We're all calling this comet Comet ISON, but of course there will be many Comet ISONs, because ISON was the group of astronomers, or the organization that discovered Comet ISON, and each one has a specific name, such as C2012S1. Same thing, of course, with C1680V1. So, as we can see, the orbit diagrams are actually very similar. As I flick backwards and forwards, we're looking out to the orbit of Mars here. That's ISON. And out to the orbit of Mars here as well for 1680. And we can see that the orbit trajectory of the comet is actually very similar to Comet ISON. Now, we're looking at these diagrams top down in a 2D view, and that can be somewhat misleading sometimes because of the angles. So what we also need to do is look at this in 3D and tilt this up and see how they compare in 3D. So we're tilting this up, so we're going to look at the orbital plane edge on. Okay, so there we go. We can see that Comet ISON is coming in this way. It's going down below the orbital plane. It's going to zip around the Sun, and then it's going to be heading out this way. In the same way, if I go to 1680 and tilt this up, same way I did with ISON, and look at that orbital plane edge on, okay, we can see the same sort of thing. And if I flick backwards and forwards, we can see that the trajectory of 1680 was actually even shallower. than Comet ISON. So, yes, this has happened before. It is not common. It's, certainly most other comets have more of a egg-shaped orbit, if you like, or a circular orbit, rather than this very pronounced, sharp sort of orbit that we're seeing here. But just to go back to the data, so Comet 1680 had an extremely close perihelion of 0.0062 AU, so that's the closest point to the Sun, compared to ISON at 0.0124. So we can see that Comet 1680 was actually a lot closer to the Sun than Comet ISON will be. So in answer to the question, or the comment, yes, this has happened before. As I say, it's not common, but it certainly has happened before. And Comet 1680 was a spectacular comet. I haven't seen Comet ISON yet. I did go out with the camera on Monday morning at 4 a.m. with the 60DA, which is very good for taking pictures of very faint objects, and I was not able to locate it myself. But hopefully in the days ahead it will be visible, and certainly as it gets closer to the Sun. Unfortunately, we will be competing with bright moonlight over the coming days. But anyway, let's keep our fingers crossed and hope that we do see a spectacular display from Comet ISON. There's certainly nothing to fear from Comet ISON. At its closest point to the Earth, it will be 64 million miles away, and it poses no risk. Even if it disintegrates as it goes around the back of the Sun, it simply means that the pieces of the comet will continue on much the same trajectory. There is no chance whatsoever that the comet will break up and end up hurtling towards the Earth. There's absolutely no chance of that happening whatsoever. You might like to do some further reading on the Great Comet of 1680. Just Google Comet 1680 and you'll find articles. There's this one on Wikipedia and several other articles online. I'll put a link in the description area for you, and you can check that out. As always, do check out my Facebook discussion page, Voices of Reason to Explain X or Vortex. There is a link in the description area. Also, on the About tab on my channel, there's a link, and also a link to my personal Facebook page. Thank you for watching.